Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Tower of the Mad Wizard. Chapter 1: The Enchanted Entrance. In the heart of a mystical land, where whispers of magic danced on the wind, and legends of ancient sorcery echoed through the valleys, stood the Tower of the Mad Wizard. Its presence loomed over the landscape like a silent sentinel, its spires piercing the sky in a defiant display of power and mystery. Armand, a seasoned wizard with a hunger for knowledge and adventure, found himself drawn to the tower's enigmatic allure. Stories of its hidden chambers, arcane secrets, and the untold power said to be concealed within its walls had long captivated his imagination. With each passing day, the urge to unravel the mysteries of the tower grew stronger, until he could resist its call no longer. Equipped with little more than his wits, a satchel of essential supplies, and the loyal companionship of his feline familiar, Merlin, Armand set out on his journey. The path to the tower wound its way through dense forests, across rolling plains, and beyond mist-covered mountains, each step bringing him closer to his destination and the promise of adventure that awaited him there. As Armand approached the tower, he could feel the air crackling with magic, a tangible sense of power that sent a thrill racing through his veins. The tower itself loomed before him, its darkened windows and looming spires casting eerie shadows upon the surrounding landscape. Yet, despite its imposing facade, Armand felt a sense of exhilaration stirring within him, a sense of purpose that drove him ever onward. With Merlin at his side, Armand stepped into the shadow of the tower, crossing the threshold into a realm of mystery and enchantment. The entrance hall stretched out before them, its walls adorned with ancient runes and symbols of power, each one pulsing with latent energy. As they ventured deeper into the tower, Armand couldn't shake the feeling that they were being watched, that unseen eyes followed their every move, and that the very walls themselves held secrets waiting to be uncovered. But he pushed aside his unease, focusing instead on the task at hand and the mysteries that lay ahead. The entrance hall seemed to stretch on for eternity, its corridors twisting and turning like the labyrinth of a madman's mind. Yet, guided by Merlin's keen senses and their own intuition, Armand pressed onward, his heart filled with a mixture of excitement and trepidation. As they reached the end of the hall, they came upon a spiral staircase, its steps spiraling upwards into the darkness above. With a sense of determination burning bright within him, Armand took the first step on his journey, his mind filled with thoughts of the adventures that lay ahead and the secrets that awaited him at the tower's summit. Each step brought them closer to their destination. The staircase winding ever upwards, like a serpent coiling in anticipation. With each floor they ascended, the air grew thicker with magic, the very essence of the tower seeping into their bones and filling them with a sense of wonder and awe. But with wonder came danger, for the tower was not without its guardians, beings of shadow and flame that lurked in the shadows, waiting to ensnare the unwary. Yet, with Merlin's wisdom and Armin's skill with magic, they were able to outwit the tower's guardians and press on towards their goal. As they climbed higher and higher, the air grew colder, the shadows deeper, and the magic more potent. Yet, with each passing moment, Armand felt his resolve strengthening, his determination unwavering in the face of adversity. At last, after what felt like an eternity, they reached the top of the staircase, emerging into a chamber bathed in soft light and filled with the hum of magic. Before them stood a door of polished ebony, its surface adorned with ancient runes and symbols of power. With a sense of anticipation coursing through him, Armand reached out and pushed open the door, revealing a chamber unlike any he had ever seen. In the center of the room stood a pedestal, upon which rested a glowing crystal, the source of the tower's power. As Armand approached the crystal, he felt its energy wash over him like a wave, filling him with a sense of awe and wonder. With Merlin at his side, he reached out and grasped the crystal in his hands, feeling its power surge through him like a bolt of lightning. But as he beheld the crystal's radiant glow, Armand knew that with great power came great responsibility. For the magic of the tower was not meant to be wielded lightly, and its true purpose was to protect the realm from darkness and despair. With a sense of purpose burning bright within him, Armand made a solemn vow to use the tower's power for the greater good, to defend the realm from those who would seek to do it harm, and to uphold the values of justice and freedom for all. And as he stood amidst the glow of the crystal, Armand knew that his journey was far from over, for the power of the tower was but one piece of the puzzle, and there were still many mysteries waiting to be unraveled in the world beyond. With Merlin by his side and the power of the tower in his hands, Armand stepped out onto the balcony overlooking the realm below, ready to face whatever challenges lay ahead, for he knew that with courage, determination, and the guidance of his wise companion, there was no obstacle that he could not overcome. Chapter 2: The Forest of Illusions. As Armand and Merlin ascended to the second floor of the Tower of the Mad Wizard, they found themselves enveloped by an ethereal mist that obscured their surroundings. The air grew dense with the scent of ancient trees and earth, and the sound of rustling leaves filled the chamber. Stepping through the threshold of the second floor, Armand felt a sense of disorientation wash over him. The walls of the chamber seemed to shimmer and shift, and the path ahead appeared to twist and turn without rhyme or reason. It was as though they had stepped into a realm where reality itself was but a fleeting illusion. Merlin, ever alert to the dangers that lurked within the tower, guided Armand through the maze-like corridors with ease. His keen senses allowed him to discern the true path from the myriad of false trails that crisscrossed the chamber, leading them deeper into the heart of the forest. As they ventured forth, Armand couldn't shake the feeling that they were being watched, that unseen eyes followed their every move, and that the very trees themselves held secrets waiting to be uncovered. Yet, with Merlin's guidance and his own intuition as a seasoned wizard, Armand pressed onward, his heart filled with determination and his mind focused on the task at hand. The forest of illusions seemed to stretch out endlessly before them, its twisted branches reaching towards the sky like skeletal fingers. Shadows danced amidst the foliage, their forms shifting and changing with each passing moment. Yet, despite the eerie atmosphere, Armand felt a sense of exhilaration stirring within him, a sense of adventure that fueled his resolve and pushed him ever forward. With Merlin leading the way, they navigated through the tangled undergrowth and avoided the snares and traps laid by unseen hands. The path ahead seemed to twist and turn without warning, leading them deeper into the heart of the forest with each passing moment. They saw weird and wonderful sights as they ventured farther into the forest. Such a clearing full of ethereal wisps, a babbling brook whose waters shimmered with an unearthly light, and a grove of glowing mushrooms. But in all the beauty of the forest, there were threats concealed in the shadows, monsters of shadow and darkness that prowled the underbrush, ready to snare the careless. But with Merlin's wisdom and Armand's skill with magic, they were able to outwit the forest's guardians and press on towards their goal. With each step forward, they uncovered clues and riddles that hinted at the true nature of the tower's magic, a power that could reshape the very fabric of reality itself. As they delved deeper into the forest's mysteries, Armand and Merlin discovered that the illusions that surrounded them were not just figments of their imagination, but manifestations of the tower's own magic. Each twist and turn of the path was a test, a trial designed to challenge their resolve and push them to their limits. But with determination burning bright within them, they pressed on, their hearts filled with the knowledge that they were one step closer to unlocking the tower's secrets. And as they emerged from the forest of illusions, blinking in the light of the chamber beyond, they knew that their journey was far from over. For the tower held many more challenges and mysteries waiting to be unraveled, and Armand and Merlin were determined to face them head on. With their courage and determination as their guide, they stepped forward into the unknown, ready to face whatever trials lay ahead in their quest to unlock the secrets of the Tower of the Mad Wizard. Chapter 3, The Lake of Reflections. As Armand and Merlin ascended to the third floor of the Tower of the Mad Wizard, they found themselves standing on the shores of a vast and tranquil lake. The water stretched out before them like a sheet of liquid glass, reflecting the moon's gentle glow and the twinkling stars above. The air was cool and still, and a sense of peace washed over Armand as he gazed out at the serene beauty of the lake. Yet, beneath its calm surface, he knew that there lay hidden mysteries waiting to be uncovered. With Merlin at his side, Armand approached the water's edge, his senses alert for any signs of danger or deception. The surface of the lake was as smooth as glass, its stillness broken only by the occasional ripple caused by a passing breeze. As they stood on the shore, Armand noticed that the reflection of the tower shimmered on the surface of the water, distorted and fragmented by the gentle motion of the waves. It was as though the lake itself held a mirror to the world, revealing hidden truths and unseen realities. With a sense of curiosity burning bright within him, Armand reached out and dipped his hand into the cool waters of the lake. As his fingers touched the surface, he felt a tingle of energy course through him, as though the very essence of the lake responded to his touch. Merlin, ever the vigilant companion, watched from the shore as Armand waded out into the shallows, his eyes scanning the depths below. The water was clear and crystal-like, allowing him to see all the way to the bottom, where strange and wondrous sights awaited. As Armand explored the depths of the lake, he discovered that it was not just a body of water, but a gateway to another realm, a realm of dreams and visions, where the past, present, and future converged in a swirling maelstrom of magic. With Merlin's guidance, Armand delved deeper into the mysteries of the lake, allowing its waters to wash over him like a tide of memories and emotions. With each passing moment, he felt himself drawn further into its depths, his mind filled with images and sensations from times long past. He saw glimpses of distant lands and forgotten memories, each one holding a clue to the tower's true purpose. He witnessed ancient battles and forgotten heroes, their deeds etched into the fabric of time like runes upon a scroll. But amidst the visions of the past, Armand also saw glimpses of the future, of worlds yet to be born and destinies yet to be fulfilled. He saw himself standing at the pinnacle of power, wielding the magic of the tower with wisdom and compassion, and he knew that his journey was far from over. Yet, the lake was not without its dangers, for it was also home to creatures of water and shadow, lurking beneath the surface and waiting to drag the unwary into its depths. Yet, with Merlin's wisdom and Armand's skill with magic, they were able to navigate the lake's treacherous waters and uncover its hidden secrets. As they delved deeper into the lake's mysteries, Armand and Merlin uncovered clues that hinted at the true nature of the tower's magic, a power that could reshape the very fabric of reality itself. With each revelation, they grew closer to unlocking the tower's final secret and claiming its power for themselves. But as they reached the center of the lake and beheld the tower's summit looming above them, Armand knew that their journey was far from over. For the greatest challenges still lay ahead, and the true test of their courage and determination was yet to come. With Merlin's encouragement and his own indomitable spirit. Armand steeled himself for the final ascent, ready to face whatever challenges awaited him at the tower's peak. And as he emerged from the depths of the lake, his mind filled with the knowledge that he was one step closer to unlocking the secrets of the Tower of the Mad Wizard. Chapter 4, The Summit of Power. At last, after overcoming countless trials and challenges, Armand and Merlin stood at the threshold of the tower's summit. Before them loomed a towering door, its surface etched with intricate runes and symbols of arcane power. With each step closer, Armand felt a surge of anticipation coursing through him, mingled with a healthy dose of apprehension. Armand took a deep breath to calm himself down before reaching out and touching the door. He felt the smooth, cool wood beneath his fingertips. The door creaked slightly as he pushed it open, revealing a chamber filled with a gentle, throbbing light. Stepping into the chamber, Armand felt a tingling sensation wash over him, as though he had stepped into the heart of a thunderstorm. The air crackled with energy, and the very walls seemed to vibrate with the power of the tower's magic. In the center of the chamber stood a pedestal, upon which rested a glowing crystal, the source of the tower's power. Its light was intense and blinding, yet Armand felt drawn to it like a moth to a flame. With Merlin at his side, Armand approached the pedestal, his heart pounding in his chest. As he reached out to touch the crystal, he felt a surge of energy wash over him, filling him with a sense of exhilaration and awe. But as he gazed into the crystal's radiant glow, Armand knew that with great power came great responsibility. The magic of the tower was not meant to be wielded lightly, and its true purpose was to protect the realm from darkness and despair. With a sense of purpose burning bright within him, Armand made a solemn vow to use the tower's power for the greater good, to defend the realm from those who would seek to do it harm, and to uphold the values of justice and freedom for all. As he reached out to grasp the crystal, Armand felt a surge of energy coursing through him, as though he had tapped into a wellspring of power beyond imagining. With Merlin's encouragement and his own indomitable spirit, he channeled the energy of the crystal, allowing it to flow through him like a river of light. In that moment, Armand felt as though he had become one with the magic of the tower, his consciousness expanding to encompass the very essence of the realm itself. He saw visions of worlds beyond worlds, of galaxies swirling in the void, and of beings of light and shadow locked in eternal struggle. But amidst the chaos and turmoil, Armand also saw glimpses of hope, a flicker of light in the darkness, a beacon of courage and determination that refused to be extinguished. And he knew that he was not alone, that there were others who shared his quest for justice and peace. With renewed resolve, Armand channeled the power of the crystal, unleashing a wave of energy that swept through the tower like a tempest. As the light of the crystal enveloped him, he felt a sense of peace wash over him, as though he had finally found his true purpose in life. And as the energy of the crystal faded and the chamber grew still once more, Armand emerged from the tower's summit victorious, his heart filled with the knowledge that he had fulfilled his destiny and unlocked the secrets of the Tower of the Mad Wizard. With Merlin by his side and the power of the tower in his hands, Armand stepped out onto the balcony, overlooking the realm below, ready to face whatever challenges lay ahead. For he knew that with courage, determination, and the guidance of his wise companion, there was no obstacle that he could not overcome. And as he disappeared into the distance, his figure growing smaller and smaller against the backdrop of the setting sun, he knew that he would always be remembered as a hero, the one who had saved the realm from darkness and restored peace to the land once more.